Sales Fred Hughes team.
Terry Wood. Michelle King. KUTV 2 News at 10.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Mary Nichols. Michelle King has the night off. It's a spring break weekend, and that means just one thing, a busy night for law enforcement across the state.
Well, from St. George to Moab to Salt Lake, authorities are out in force tonight, and much of their efforts are aimed at getting drunk drivers off the road. Channel 2's Carrie Birmingham spent this evening with members of the Salt Lake County Sheriff's Department. She joins us now. Carrie, what's happening tonight?
Well, Terry, tonight we went up and down Big and Little Cottonwood Canyons with the Alcohol Enforcement Project. Now, this is a group of 6 to 8 deputies who get some volunteer overtime funded by a federal grant. They're targeting kids, and just as you said, they're trying to keep drunk drivers off the road. Now, tonight, it's a pretty cold night up here. The wind is blowing, but there were still kids out in the canyons drinking. Police got several arrests tonight for minor in possession, also for possession of marijuana, and also for kids drinking and driving. Last year, when this group started, over the period of June to September, they got over 1,000 arrests. Most of those were 18, 19, and 20-year-olds, but 300 juveniles were also arrested. And what they're trying to do here is cut down on the reputation that the canyons are a fun place for kids to go and party. And they're basically trying to get the word out that canyon roads and alcohol don't mix.
Obviously, drunk driving is a hazard any place. But for an inexperienced young driver, a canyon road is even more dangerous.
Sheriff deputies believe through this project they've saved many lives. They think they've prevented accidents out here. They say they've cut down on the number of DUIs because kids are starting to get the message that if they're up here and they're drinking, the sheriff's deputies are going to be out looking for them. Terry?
Carrie, we also understand there was a problem up at Brighton tonight, a carbon monoxide problem. What can you tell us about that?
About a half a dozen people were up in a canyon up Big Cottonwood Canyon at Brighton, and they started feeling sick. They called police and they called sheriff's deputies out. Everybody was able, all six people were able to get out of that cabin okay. Three were transported to the hospital, but we understand they are in good condition. It was, as you said, a carbon monoxide leak. One of the heaters in the home was leaking carbon monoxide, and those people tonight are very lucky to be alive.
Certainly are. Okay, thank you very much. That's Carrie Birmingham reporting live from Big Cottonwood Canyon. Now, police are out in full force in the Moab area, too. Four-wheelers and spring breakers turned Grand County into a grand party over the Easter weekend, and it can get dangerous. Red rocks, warm weather, four-wheel drive, and six-packs. That sums up Easter weekend in Moab. So far this weekend, two people have died, one when his car rolled, and a 12-year-old boy when he rolled his ATV. Several others have been hospitalized. Local, state, and federal law enforcement, they're all out, and even in the sky, keeping an eye on the crowds. Police say it's the juveniles who give them the most trouble.
The juveniles come down here, they drink a lot. They like to raise cane because they're away from mom and dad. I don't know if mom and dad knows that's what they're doing. I'm sure they're saying, we're coming down here to go four-wheeling, mountain biking, rock climbing, that kind of thing like that, which is great. But the alcohol takes effect and then things happen. You know, stupid things happen.
Saturday and Sunday see the biggest crowds in Moab and the biggest problems. Channel 2 has a crew in Moab. We will have more on the news tomorrow night.
And in Kearns tonight, a two-alarm fire broke out just before 8 o'clock at the Western Hills Elementary School. It only took fire crews 5 minutes to put the blaze out, but the fire had already burned an alcove of the building and was spreading fast. The assistant fire chief for the county says the fire looks like it was intentionally set just outside the building near an entryway. There was no damage to the inside of the school, but the alcove was burned pretty badly and some windows had to be broken out. Police and Granite School District security are at the scene investigating arson and maybe other vandalism at the school. A San Francisco child advocacy group is accusing Utah officials of breaking promises. A year ago, the state of Utah promised in court to take better care of the 1,500 neglected and abused kids in the child welfare system. But now the National Center for Youth Law says the state has violated the court decree. And tomorrow, an independent monitoring panel is expected to blast the state for its failure to better protect children. Channel 2's Michael Rosten has our report.
A year ago, state officials and child advocates settled a bitter lawsuit with the state promising better protection for Utah's 1,500 foster children. But child advocates argue that kids in the system aren't any better off than they were a year ago, and they're worse off in some cases. An independent monitoring panel will say tomorrow the state has failed to comply with the promises it made last year. Certainly, changes have begun with the hiring of 100 new social workers, 16 new assistant attorneys general, several new juvenile judges, and 20 additional attorney advocates for foster kids. But the National Center for Youth Law, which filed the lawsuit against the state in 1993, says caseworkers are still doing shoddy investigations and children aren't better protected. And inquiries by child advocates concerning foster kids being abused and neglected are being stonewalled in apparent violation of last year's court settlement. Youth law attorney Bill Grimm spoke to Channel 2 News via satellite from San Francisco this afternoon.
I think the children have really suffered further injury, abuse, and neglect as a result of the foot dragging by the agency in responding to our request. Their responses have been evasive, they have been deceptive, and I think in some instances they've been downright dishonest in responding to our request for information about individual children.
Fundamentally untrue.
Governor Leavitt's spokesperson Vicky Varela says state officials are working hard, but they're overwhelmed.
We have an enormous and growing problem. We have hired additional social workers, we have appropriated millions of dollars, and most of all, we have identified plans that create a better safety net for those children. We have made enormous progress, and we will continue to make progress.
On Monday, Governor Leavitt will travel the state trying to put the best possible spin to this most recent criticism. He meets with some 700 caseworkers with the Division of Family Services, offering support and encouragement to beleaguered employees involved in the most difficult of all state jobs, protecting Utah's abused children. Michael Rawson, Channel 2 News.
The Center for Youth Law's Bill Grimm says the heart of the problem with Utah's child welfare system is a crisis of leadership. He says that's exemplified by the Division of Family Services appointing lawyers and not child advocates to head that agency. The state of Utah may also come under scrutiny for a new report that shows minority juvenile offenders get tougher treatment in Utah's justice system than whites. The findings show that Anglo youths proportionately commit more crimes than minority kids, but the University of Utah study says more minorities end up at detention and they get tougher treatment in all phases of justice.
There's a lot of different stereotyping that goes on. Very subtle. There could be a lot of subtle prejudice that people just overlook.
Because there's this combative attitude between law enforcement and the minority community, and because the minority community has had so many more
it's a downhill line. Oh, that'll make it, or is it too high?
Too high, I think.
Just, oh, yes! You bounced, and almost, hey, you almost hit the wood duck house. That bounced right straight toward the wood duck house.
Well, I landed right at the pin. I would have been on the green.
Yep.
Probably the closest one I've had to the green yet.
What are you hitting?
Five. I knew I could get a five over, but it's got to be the right hit.
Lost it.
Straight out, a little bit over to the high, a little bit high. Should be short.
Yep just short. Oh. Heard it hit rock, yeah.
Oh. And the ball is so dark I couldn't tell.
Looked
what it
like
was.
Like a stone laying there. Lots of bounce left in that one. Oh yeah, that's up there. Oh, way
in
back.
The woods, into the woods.
Way back. You're gonna have to teach me how to golf one of these days.
That was good. Just have a hard time getting a five across. Now I know I can get it across and have a little bit of spare.
been doing out there?
Fire going already?
What? Snagged? Yeah, it looks like the battery on the camera's going dead. We'll plug it in while we're gone. What?
What was it the kids were doing?
I had a foam rubber thing on the motor. Because that, where you grab a hold of it, there's a connection to put a steering control on it.
Oh.
And,
knocked it off?
It's gone.
Yeah.
I don't know what
par
I'm getting.
Par 4D chorus, though.
What?
Par 4D.
Shut down, completely blocking travel into or out of the city.
I was just thinking, we never did have anything
on the inside,
on the inside, and I can't hardly get anything either.
Too tight?
Yeah.
Now,
what'd you find out with your boat?
We didn't go up to Tomahawk.
Oh,
it was so nice out, we decided to go fishing.
Room in the place.
It's a problem residents have grown accustomed to.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
The river has been flooding several times a year since 1903.
Just first, devastating to go through this, especially if you take care of the
The mayor said it would be a couple of days before anyone could be allowed to return to their homes and survey the damage. Back in Houston, Gene Simmons is trying to put this little disaster behind him.
Teachers hold contract negotiations again today with school officials. They're focusing on a state budget surplus, part of which is supposed to be funded in the school district, according to the law. It is the fifth day of the walkout, and the number of students attending classes continues to drop. But strangely, while the academic summer, athletics of some schools are in
trouble.
Patty Finich explains.
What's that?
Despite the teacher strike, most of LA's coaches have decided it's okay to pick it in the morning and coach in the afternoon.
Windows on outside.
Then I'll be there.
What's a whatever catch?
Let's see, MJ.
Ugly little sucker, isn't he?
You should check this out there. I just watched it separate itself from the other half of the world.
Thank you.
Okay, this is just about a 360 degree turn here. Just coming around the cottage. Going right back out. Okay, here we've got Ron getting the boat in for the first time while I was up here, at least. First time the day has gotten to be halfway nice out. Blue skies after about 3 days of cloudy, dreary, drizzly weather. There he goes. Pretty nice looking boat there. Probably could pull at least two water skiers. Now if he does this just right, we'll have a perfect smash landing onto the dock here. Oh, there's one start. Try it again. One more time. Ever. That's Polish for you, reverse to begin with. The other direction, Ron, the other direction. There you go. That one's gone. Didn't take long, did it? Here he comes again, flying by. Hold your finger up, Ron. Nobody's driving. Okay, here's the back door of the cottage. And for those of you that aren't familiar with the Wizard of Oz, this is the Red Brick Road. The Red Brick Road just kind of takes you around the corner. And where else could the Red Brick Road lead to? Here we are, the original brick shithouse, complete with its roll of toilet paper, venting so it doesn't stink. I bet they don't have these in Canada. Okay, this is the walkway over to the backwoods. Going here. And then take the second bridge. And then, okay, now from the second bridge, we'll have to start doing a little bit of walking here. ought to give you a little bit of a feel for the way that walking goes on this bridge here. Kind of springy. You would almost need a shock absorber to go across that bridge any speed. Okay, now, this is not the best attempt here at walking with the camera, but if I can thread the needle through the trees here. Kind of get myself around here. Carrie Jo made a tape just like this. And I liked it, so I thought I'd put it on ours. Unfortunately, the one she had, we were looking right at the ground. And I kind of wanted to see some of the trees. Okay, now we're just about out to the point. Got a real windy day going on here right now. You should be able to see the nice blue waters out there. A few birch trees back here, I'd say. Here's that wind blowing. Most of your canyon winds a shame right there. Okay, and this is kind of a big opening once you get back here, if you want to go tenting or whatever. Kids have got about 5 extra little trails that they've carved out of here in the last year since I've been here, so that they can easily get to their little fishing holes. On the earlier frames, you should have saw island that we kept zooming in on when we took the pictures of the cottage. And if you can just see out into the water there, that's the same little island. We're just coming up on it right now. Sure, it's a bucket on a tree. It's a duck house. It's supposed to look a little bit more like the one over there that you see kind of hiding back there with the bottom on it. If I can walk in here without tripping over a stump. Take a little zoom in here of Rajic's cottage. Standing right on the bank now, just about ready to fall into the water, so here we're gonna zoom out there and see what Rajic looks like. Can't probably quite see it on the film here, but the front pillars that thing stands on are actually tipped out and away from the base. They aren't probably gonna use that cottage anymore. This is kind of cutting back into the cove. Pine tree right there is typically where you'll see the eagles landing. Now we're coming back across the river here to a little island. And that'd be about most of it right there. Here's a good example how just a simple little piece of wood can look so pretty up here. Just tucked back in there perfectly. Makes a nice shot. Well, there we had got Grandma cleaning out the backyard.
I didn't know you were doing that to me.
Of course she didn't know I was doing it. I'm sneaky. And besides, I'm just a little ways away. Way back here on the second dock landing. But this is probably one of the only good shots you'll see of the back side of the country. What's that? Certainly do, Grandma.
I thought you were in a can because the door was open.
See what happens when you leave a big brick shit house open? It's way over here. Comes the wind again. From the back of the cottage now to the gazebo. Standing back out, you can see how much the waves are being kicked around today. Yeah, Ron said they should have the microphone cover. Much wind is coming out here, I think he's right. He's coming around here by Louie's cottage. They're just setting up to put their dock in. And that was actually a little bit farther over, but look real hard. Somewhere in that nice grassy spot over there should be one of my golf balls that I drove yesterday. Steve made me a bet if I could put it in the chimney, he'd stay for the weekend. But one club short. Okay, this is the base of one of the great redwoods here of Wisconsin. Really a great redwood. This is a piece of driftwood that just happened to have to be dragged up here on shore. Thank you.
Where is she?
We took some water. Did you get that on film?
How's the water, Kay?
Take a little bit of water.
You're trying to kill me.
Do you know your friend that would go down that much?
Happened to us too. Dad!
What?
Don't go back and forth so fast.
Okay.
It's my first time out, you know.
Wow, that's
okay, I'll go with you later.
Hey,
go ahead.
Ready?
No, wait, I gotta sit down. That big butt right in the middle of my view. Now we have Carrie and Katie. Two little fools.
fly again. walk in there. Thank you.
second set of waves. Please pick them up on the board. And here it gets. No problem. That was so much fun, we should do it again. Well, here comes some. Good landing. Thrusters, there we are. Back out on the boat again. Got me up front this time so we can balance out the weight a little bit here.
That's right, it is cold.
In the boat?
Yeah.
Oh, there it is again, cottage. Nice trees there already.
Oh, you guys, this is close reaching off the ground.
Now we'll carry you.
And that's the dam.
You go on one and have two on the other one, so the weight's kind of evened out.
There There's the first island, the second
You're
island,
freezing.
And
I
the
bet
dam.
You don't even have a towel here. No,
and backing out. There's the corner.
Except this.
Going back from the cottage. Wake up. Ron's going to step in front of me here,
probably. Okay, you ready?
And there we are. Ready for takeoff. If I don't fall over, hold on to this camera, we'll be in good shape. We're down to three.
Hey, Kim.
Last one
Kim.
Stepped off on the last grouping because it's too cold.
Did that work better for the whips if I got the other girls on the outside?
It's great the way they get along so well together here. Okay, we're pretty well set.
All right. Are you ready?
Ready for the V4?
Right,
I'm okay. Punch it. And we're up. But we're up. You know, well, I could do standing up there for a second. It's gonna be great when I get to the bridge and get my head knocked off.
You did not want to stand up.
Yeah, that's what I just said. So let me know when we get to the bridge.
Other boots.
here. You gotta hold it on now after all those sticks. Holding onto the camera for the last 20 minutes here. That should be good.
What we're after doing, Jay, we're gonna have to get out of here.
I don't know if I did or not.
Well, it's the start anyway.
By golly, look at that. Carrie, you're doing a hell of a good job planting flowers. You want to sit out in the sun, Ray, or? Huh? You're all right.
Yeah.
Dad, Chris, you're going on the tour.
Yep.
Toadstools are doing better there.
Yeah, we get some patients who are on the outside. That'll be pretty.
That looks nice with the mushrooms, eh?
We want to get some trilliums for it.
Trilliums? Where are we planning to get them?
Right in there,
all
for matter of fact.
All we have to do is pull into that Menard thing here.
I think all we should do is go there and go someplace and take like a nice little section and plant them in there where nobody wants.
Almost just about had one there.
Have an accident.
do you ride this thing? You have your feet inside or you have them outside?
Okay. Any way you want.
Any way you want, huh?
Just lay them on it.
Right like that. I would hang them off the back end.
Not like this, huh?
You can, but you'll tip over.
I'll put my feet on the outside.
Somebody stick
a sign on my back that says crazy.
Smile. Turn that off.
Find the right hole? Looks that way.
Yeah, you are. Wait till the rope comes tight.
I guess we go.
Are you ready?
Got to get on from the back, not the side. Go, hon.
Thank you.
gonna go again.
That festival wrecks your fingertips. You
is that fun?
That was good, huh?
Is that fun?
Yeah, that was fun. I think we'll go back to skiing. It's safer.
You want to ride the tube in?
Yeah.
Jeez, rope tape.
Claire, say hi, Claire.
Hi, Claire, how are you?
This is Moon.
This is welcome to the family time, right?
Yeah, yeah. Congratulations.
Ron?
Yeah.
He combed his hair for Claire, you know?
Right, I got that.
That way you can see what you like.
I wonder if she knows it.
Malik, who's the name we got married? Back in Utah.
Oh, Judy.
Then we decided about, you know, how separate.
We got to get all you guys on film here.
This is separate.
Get that pontoon boat there.
That's the only way to go.
Okay.
Now, but you don't know how much pizza I get.
Say hi, Claire.
Oh.
Well, I know we can't eat that.
Hanging up the tube, and Dad and Jay are getting ready to go out fishing. It's digging up the worms. Find any?
Not many.
Out of all the ones we picked?
No, I forgot to bring them. I never thought of it.
Oh.
We got, what, 6 dozen at home? Yeah. This would be enough. You're going to throw your pole out for bullheads or whatnot?
Sure.
I'm sure you can find one or two in here. You're going to have to dig for me.
All the things hanged up to dry. The mosquitoes are really bad. Hope you sprayed yourself, Dad.
Yeah.
First non-alcoholic beverage of the weekend.
We only got 8 more days left of school.
Yeah, I said, well, like I said, it seems to me like if you just, follow them up after you award the contract and let them know they won it.
Trying to ward off the mosquitoes.
Take care of most of the problem. Same way we have a budget, though. Okay, go. It's too expensive to call these people.
Bring back a big one. And into the sun. Ugh, nasty mosquitoes. But we'll see them when they get back.
I am so good. Hey, how you guys over there doing? Zoom in on them and show them what a real fisherman is. This is me.
What a real fisherman.
This was great. You should have seen the swirl.
Oh, forgot about my fish.
It was just whoosh, whoosh. It was great. You mean you should have seen the swirl?
You got blood on me with him.
You're not keeping it, are you?
Should I?
No. It's not big enough.
I can get some good fillets off him.
No, he ain't big enough.
I will let him go. Catch and release!
Yeah, I'm so good!
Let's go fishing. Over there.
It's not big enough, Rick.
One more. There's got to be more out there. Hey, that's the first pole you'll cherry what's got. The first fish. Look at them pants. He wants to wear pants because the mosquitoes are bad.
I think I'd probably stay on, but...
Give that guy a rope to hold his camera.
He'll be sitting down, no problem.
There's some binder twine laying outside, I think.
Look at that, get some binder twine.
Goes Rick, Scott, and Jim.
Yo, I'm out, yo, man.
Don't rock the boat or you'll tip over. They got one.
Did Rick tell you his fish story already?
What?
Did Rick tell you his fish story already?
Oh. I heard something about a muskie up here.
One cast.
Another?
Are you releasing it?
Yeah.
Well, wait, let me get up there then.
Jeez, look at that.
Yeah. So now we know exactly how long it is.
It's a pretty nice one.
Well, we're going to put them back so I can come catch them next year.
What do you got in your line?
What is that, a crappie or what?
Walleye.
Well, that's a crappie. I know it's not a crappie. I meant walleye. Sure.
Out here.
Stay upright? Yeah. He might have drowned when we dragged him on. How his fins are going.
No, he's pretty wide. He's been kicking him.
Yeah, but he won't stay upright by himself, huh? The globe was. Yeah, he's getting there.
What?
Back to the deep he goes.
What?
All right. You have a bite.
Boom.
All right, babe, what do you go, man?
on too yet.
Remember that Babe Winkle one, Dad, you did?
This
oh,
is
I
a
caught
little some, bitty one.
I caught real big ones.
Yeah, here's a tiny one.
Hang on, come from the belly. Come over and grab it, like.
Carrie, that's a real good view of you.
Excuse me.
You want to get them?
Get a chance to get a beer here.
Follow. You need one without.
Here's what it's like to get married and spend 3 days away from your wife. Not blue balls, purple.
No. You need a follow without an ad in it.
Oh, I'll get you one of those.
How's this? A blue one or not?
Oh my God. The damn balloon run out of air. Yeah, my goodness gracious. I think you're sexy.
I think you're drunk.
Right. Yeah?
Here you go, Jay.
You need one, Jay, and I.
Sherry Joe's in the mouth.
There, now I sound right. There, now I sound right.
I don't know what you mean, but the plane's here.
The plane.
Bartender, can I have a drink? Because, I mean, I'm really thirsty. You know, the problem about these balloons is that they all get empty before you get to Willy Wonka land. Then you don't get no chocolate. So, bye-bye, good night. Oh, look out, balloon's coming.